This is Jawadamat from Medicos Lectures by GD, and today we are going to start a series of videos on the parasitology. In this video, we will be mainly covering the main terminologies that are used in the parasitology, and after that we will classify the parasites. So let's have a start. First of all, what exactly is parasitology? Now, the parasitology is the study of the parasites, their hosts, and the relationship between them. It is the study of the parasites, their hosts, and the relationship between them. So parasites, the study of the parasite. First of all, we will study that where it mainly causes the disease and in which morphological form it is present and how is it diagnosed and the different forms of it. So that study of the parasite. After that, their host. We will study that that parasite lives in which host or on which host. So we will study their host, and after that the relationship between the parasite and the host, mainly the various diseases that the parasite will be causing in their host. So this whole is the scope of the parasitology. So again, parasitology is the study of the parasites, their hosts, and the relationship between them. Now we will take one at a time. First of all, the parasite, then the host, and then the relationship between them. So first of all, the parasite. What exactly is a parasite? So a parasite is an organism which lives in or on another organism, and it gains its benefit by harming the host. So that parasite, it is that very organism that lives on another organism, or it lives inside the another organism, and it causes harm to that organism, and as a result it gains benefit. Mainly it gains food or nutrients or shelter mainly. So it gets its benefit by harming the host. Say for example, we have the classical example of the Plasmodium. Say for example, here over here is the female Anopheles mosquito. When it bites the human being, as a result what happens, that Plasmodium enter into the human body, and that Plasmodium then enter into the red blood cell, and it causes the lysis of the red blood cell. So as a result, the Plasmodium multiply in numbers. So it gains its benefit, but by harming the host, because it is causing the lysis of the red blood cell. So a parasite is an organism that gets its benefit by harming the host. We will get to the different types of the parasite and the different classification of the parasite later, but first just we will cover the basic terminologies like the host and the different relationship. So let's move forward towards the host. Now what exactly is a host? So a host is that organism on which the parasite lives or in which the parasite lives. We have studied in the definition of the parasite that it is an organism that lives on or inside another organism. So that very organism is called as its host. Now the host may be, it may be a definitive host or it may be an intermediate host. So a definitive host is that host in which the sexual reproduction of the parasite take place. So the sexual reproduction of the parasite will take place in its definitive host, whereas its asexual reproduction will take place in the intermediate host. Say for example, we are talking about the Plasmodium. So the Plasmodium asexually reproduces in the human body. So the human body becomes its intermediate host, whereas its sexual reproduction takes place in the mosquito. So the mosquito is its definitive host. So that's all about the host. Let's move forward. And the next is the relationship between them. So we have studied that the parasitology is the study of the parasites, their host, and the relationship between them. So before going to the relationship between the parasite and the host, let's study the different relationship between the different organisms. So any type of the close and long-term biological interaction between the two different biological organisms is called as symbiosis. Whenever two organisms in a biological system lives together and for a long period and interact with one another, so that relationship is called as symbiosis. Now this interaction may be one of the following. First of all, mutualism. In the mutualism, it is a type of the symbiosis in which the both organisms are benefited. So you can say it is a type of the true love when both of them live happily ever after. So both of them gets benefit, and it is called as mutualism, this type of the interaction. The second one is the commensalism. So the commensalism is a type of the symbiosis in which one organism is benefited, while as the other organism is neither benefited nor harmed. It is a type of symbiosis in which one organism is benefited, whereas the other organism is neither benefited nor harmed. Now the third one is the parasitism, which will be our main focus in the parasitology. So the parasitism is that type of relationship in which one organism is benefited, whereas the other organism is harmed. Say, for example, we have studied the plasmodium, that the plasmodium is benefited, but the human body is, that is harmed. So this is, this will be our center of discussion, the parasitism. The another, it may be amensalism. So amensalism is a type of symbiosis in which there is, it is harmful to one, whereas there is neither benefit or not harm to the another. So it is a type of symbiosis in which one organism get harm, whereas the other organism is neither benefited nor harmed. Finally, the fourth one is the synecrosis. So in the synecrosis, both the organisms are harmed. So it is harmful. The synecrosis is harmful to both of the organism. So these are the various type of interaction between the organisms, but our main topic of discussion will be the parasitism, and in the parasitism we will study that the one organism, that will be the parasite, that will get benefit, whereas the other organism, that will be our host, so that will be harmed. And that host mainly, since we are we will be talking about the medically relevant parasites, so we, that host will be human body mainly, so that will be harmed. So that's all the interaction. Let's move forward. And our next and main topic is the classification of the parasites. Now this is very, very important, the classification of the parasite, that how we classify the parasite. First of all, parasites can be classified into the ectoparasite and endoparasite. Now the ectoparasite are those parasites which lives outside the body of the host, whereas the endoparasites are those parasites which lives inside the body of the host. So you can classify parasites on this basis, that where they are present. The second one is the temporary or the permanent, the parasite. So a temporary parasite is that parasite that comes to the its host for some time, whereas the permanent parasite is that parasite that lives mainly throughout its life cycle, throughout its life on the host. So it lives throughout its life cycle, where it comes for some period of time, the temporary one. The next classification is obligatory and the facultatory parasite. So the obligatory parasite is that parasite which will be always parasite, which we cannot live outside the body of the host. Whereas the facultative parasite will be that parasite that can live outside of the body of the host, means it can live independently, but it also cause human diseases, or it will also infect the host. And finally, the main classification on which we will study the different parasites, so that is our protozoa and metazoa. So this classification is basically based on the cellularity, that if the parasite is unicellular, it is placed in the protozoa, and if it is multicellular, it is placed in the metazoa. So this classification is based on the cellularity, and we will be discussing it in more detail. So let's get the details. So we have divided the parasites on the cellularity basis. We have divided them into protozoa and metazoa. Protozoa are the unicellular organism, whereas the metazoa are the multicellular organism. So the study of the metazoa is also called as helminthology. Now the protozoa is further divided on the basis of the locomotory organ into four classes. So on the presence of the locomotory organs, over here some will have pseudopodia, some will have cilia, some will have flagella. So on the basis of that, the protozoa are divided further. First of all, its first class is class Rhizopoda, or we also call as amoeba. So these organisms have the organ of locomotion of these organisms is pseudopodia. So they move with the help of pseudopodia, and mainly its example is Entamoeba histolytica. You can remember that. Okay, our second class is class Zoomastigophora. These are flagellates, so they move with the help of flagella. First one, the class Rhizopoda, move with the help of pseudopodia, and these move with the help of flagella. And a classical example of it is Giardia lamblia. Now this third one is class Ciliata or ciliate. So as the name indicates, they move with the help of cilia. And the fourth one is class Telospora, and this class doesn't have any organ of locomotion. So these are the four classes of the protozoa: the Rhizopoda, Zoomastigophora, Ciliata, and Telospora. They have amoeba, have pseudopodia, flagella, cilia, and no organ of locomotion. So So now we will come toward the metazoa or the helminths. These are the multicellular. Remember, protozoans are unicellular. All these organisms will be unicellular organism, whereas all these organism and its further classification will be multicellular organism. So the metazoa is further divided into the platyhelminthes and nematohelminthes. The platyhelminthes are the flatworms, their bodies are flat, whereas the nematohelminthes are the roundworms and their bodies are rounded. So on the basis of the body structure they are divided. So the platyhelminthes is further divided into two classes, class Cystoda and class Trematoda. Now the class Cystoda, the cystodes, they are called as the tapeworms. So they have a body which is usually segmented. They have segmented bodies, and those segments are broader than longer. You have to remember this. Their bodies are segmented, and these segments are broader than longer. Also, they have hooks and suckers and this that we will study out later. But remember that these are the tapeworms and they have segmented bodies. And the second class is the class Trematoda. These are flukes. Their bodies is also flattened, but their bodies are leaf-like. So they are called as flukes. So that's all about the classification of the parasite. And I hope you like the video. Thank you for watching, and subscribe my channel for further upcoming videos. Thank you again.